हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक इन ज्योग्राफी वर्ल्ड। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ए न्यू चैप्टर, वाटर इन द एटमॉस्फेयर, चैप्टर 11th, पार्ट 1। इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरियस फॉर्म्स ऑफ वाटर, एवेपोरेशन, कंडेंसेशन, आफ्टरवर्ड्स क्लाउड्स, इट्स टाइप्स, टाइप्स ऑफ रेनफॉल एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ रेनफॉल एटसेट्रा। फर्स्टली, एज वी नो दैट देयर इज़ अ कॉन्टिन्यूस एक्सचेंज ऑफ वाटर in the atmosphere, the in between the oceans and continents, through the process of evaporation, transpiration, condensation and precipitation. So what is evaporation, transpiration, condensation and precipitation? We all discuss in detail in the next slides. Here we are start this chapter with the topic water in the atmosphere, in which form? As we see, the water always in the liquid form, as we used to drink water many times in a day, always in liquid form. But even we use water in the solid form also, as we use the ice cubes which we freezed in our refrigerators. But in gaseous form, the use of water in gaseous form, we are not able to see, because it is not part of our common activities. Water is always in gaseous form during evaporation. So evaporation is a process when the water converts in the gaseous form. So as we know that, or you already learned that, the air contains water vapor. So which makes the water to move from one place to another in gaseous form or even in the form of clouds. So it is the air. So the water vapor present in the air is known as humidity. So I think you well understand what is humidity. It is the water vapor present in the air. Now, how we know that what is the humidity of any air? We can calculate in various types, as humidity is classified into two types. Otherwise, it also classified into three types. But here we are going to discuss about only two types, that is absolute humidity and relative humidity. Specific humidity we are not going to discuss. So firstly, absolute humidity. I am going to clear you one thing, that humidity is the same, but our way of calculate the humidity are varies. So its types are varies according to the ways of calculation. Firstly, absolute humidity. It is the actual amount of water vapor present in the atmosphere is absolute humidity. During this, we calculate the humidity as the weight of water vapor per unit volume of air. So that's why it is expressed in the units grams per cubic meter. You know that what is cube? So during the calculations of absolute humidity, we use the air in cubic meters and total weight of water in grams. So here, in this way, we can say that absolute humidity is calculated in grams per cubic meter, as it is the total weight of water vapors in the air. So the absolute humidity always differs from place to place on the surface of Earth, because the climate, the warmness and coldness of air always varies from one surface to another according to altitude and latitude also. So that's why absolute humidity always varies. It varies from 0 to 4% by volume of the atmosphere. So next is the relative humidity. The percentage of moisture present in the atmosphere as compared to its full capacity at a given temperature is relative humidity. So relative humidity, when we calculate the humidity in percentage, means 4%, 3%, 5%. So percentage of which thing? Percentage of total capacity ऑफ एयर मीन्स दैट सपोज दैट कि यू आर एबल टू डू वर्क फॉर 10 आवर्स बट यू आर डूइंग ओनली 4 आवर्स सो योर कैपेसिटी means of 10 hours and you are doing work 4 hours then how much percentage of total your capacity you are doing so in the same way total capacity of air to hold moisture then when the air reaches at the level where its full capacity will used matlab it is saturated jab uski capacity khatam ho jati hai full capacity pe chali jati hai then इट रिलीज द मॉइस्चर इन वेरियस फॉर्म्स सो बट बिफोर दिस पॉइंट द टोटल वाटर वेपर्स प्रेजेंट इन द परसेंटेज अकॉर्डिंग टू इस कैपेसिटी इज द रिलेटिव ह्यूमिडिटी सो विद द चेंज ऑफ एयर टेम्परेचर द कैपेसिटी टू रिटेन मॉइस्चर इंक्रीजिज और डिक्रीजिज एंड द रिलेटिव ह्यूमिडिटी ऑल्सो अफेक्टेड सो इट इज दैट्स वाई इट इज ग्रेटर ओवर द ओशियंस ओशियंस पे हमेशा ह्यूमिडिटी ज़्यादा होती है बट It is always least over the continental areas. So next are important terms evaporation and condensation. In the previous slide we had discussed about the humidity. Humidity as we discussed ki when its full capacity is used at a given temperature kyunki cold temperature when there is a cold temperature then the capacity is low. एज दैट कि काफ़ी ज़्यादा एज्ड हो जाते हैं उनकी कैपेसिटी कम हो जाती है यंग जनरेशन की ज़्यादा होती है इन द सेम वे कैपेसिटीज आल्सो वेरीज इन द वेरियस टेम्परेचर्स सो वार्म टेम्परेचर द कैपेसिटी इज़ हाई सो दैट्स वाई व्हेन द एयर विल सैचुरेटेड फुल एट द गिवन टेम्परेचर देन दैट पॉइंट इज नोन एज ड्यू पॉइंट एंड द एयर इज नोन एज सैचुरेटेड एयर I think you understand what is saturated air when the full capacity is used by air and the point where this saturations occur is known as dew point. So it has a relation with evaporation and condensation. So the process by which water is transformed from liquid to gaseous state is known as evaporation. So evaporation means when anything means water here when water is converted in gaseous form from the liquid then it is known as evaporation jaise ki sunlight ki wajah se oceans mein se lakes mein se even a good example of evaporation is your clothes when you display your clothes on a wire in sunshine then after some time they are dry so Where was water go? So where will water go? तो water कहाँ चला जाता है So it get evaporate in the form of gas. So आप जो कपड़े सुखाते हैं तो वो evaporation की सबसे बड़ी example है So next is condensation. The transformation of water vapor into water is called condensation. So condensation when anything condenses fully. And when air get condensed, then it release the moisture. After having dew point, it is total condensed, and then it starts releasing its water vapor in the form of water or maybe in solid forms. So the excess water vapor condenses to solid form if it is directly condenses. To form is called sublimation then what is sublimation it is also important term when the excess of water vapor condenses into liquid form as we discussed but if it is directly condenses into solid form जब सीधा water vapor से कोई ice particles जैसे बर्फ पड़ती है पहाड़ों में so it is example when it is directly convert into solid form then the process is known as sublimation I think you understand about this what is sublimation then afterwards the next point is the condensation nuclei here we can say that it is hygroscopic nuclei to ye कंडेंसेशन होती कैसे है वॉट इज़ द वे ऑफ दिस कंडेंसेशन सपोज दैट during the smoke or during volcanic eruption and so many activities where there are some solid particles go in the atmosphere. Go in the atmosphere, and they always act like a hygroscopic nucleus, and water vapor starts condenses around this nucleus, and the formation of cloud formation start. So in this way, all solid particles, they are made from dust, smoke, salt from oceans, they always act like a nuclei, and they observe water. That's why they act a nucleus for the water vapors, and water vapor starts together around these nucleus, and there is a formation of clouds and the process of condensation starts. So another, what are the favoring factors for the condensation? Firstly, the temperature of the air is reduced to a dew point with its volume remaining constant. दो थिंग बातें हैं. फर्स्ट इज टेम्परेचर, सेकेंड इज वॉल्यूम. इफ द वॉल्यूम ऑफ वाटर वेपर इंक्रीज ऑलवेज अकॉर्डिंग टू इट्स कैपेसिटी, देन इट मीन्स द कंडेंसेशन और द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ रेन विल स्टार्ट. बट अनदर पॉइंट इज द टेम्परेचर. When temperature of air is reduced, we know that the cold air have low capacity to retain moisture and the warm air have high capacity to retain moisture. Jab temperature kam hona shuru ho jata hai, suppose that, look here, if air is spread in a vast area, when the air gets heat, it starts expanding, but when temperature decreases, it starts contracting in a small area. तो area कम हो जाता है, total weight per area बढ़ जाता है, per cubic meter बढ़ जाता है. So in this way, when temperature reduced, the dew point starts occurred. So which is condensation, first factor. When both the volume and temperature are reduced, it is the second factor. Volume भी बढ़ गया, नीचे से moisture ले लिया air ने, टेम्परेचर भी रिड्यूस हो गया, तो देन बोथ फैक्टर्स हो रहे हैं, तो ऑलवेज एयर गेट सैचुरेटेड, देन द मॉइस्चर इज एडेड टू द एयर थ्रू एवेपोरेशन. थर्ड मीन्स टोटल वॉल्यूम का बढ़ जाना. व्हेन एयर मूव्स फ्रॉम द वाटर बॉडीज, देन एयर ऑलवेज गेट मॉइस्चर फ्रॉम द वाटर बॉडीज लाइक ओशियंस. सो व्हेन इट गेट्स मॉइस्चर, टोटल वेट विल इंक्रीज एंड द condensation will occur. So these are some favorable factors for the condensation, but the main role is of temperature and of the volume of water vapors present in the air. So in the next slide, we will discuss about the water vapor or the moisture in the atmosphere in various forms.